Alien Chronicles, Part 2, The Crimson Claw. This is the story of the time before. A time when the Empire of the V's stretched across the galaxy. The V's had spread their dominion over worlds uncounted, turning the native populations into a servant species. They called their subjects Abiru, talking animals. Any creature that did not possess the pebbled, scale-like skin of the V's, or their elegant colored rill collars that raised or lowered according to their emotions, or hide its tail beneath the folds of the finest silks, as did the V's, was considered beneath notice, fit only to be enslaved. Chief among the Abiru were the Arun, the Mile, and the Kelf. The Arun were large but graceful hunters, covered with soft, striped fur. The passionate Arun possessed sharp claws and teeth, and soft, gentle eyes. Long ago, their homeworld of wide grassland had been destroyed by the V's. Born to hunt on the open plains, they had been condemned to the squalor of V's cities. The Mile had been enslaved as scholars and thinkers, small with thick manes of fur around their necks and prehensile tails. The thoughtful Mile were lovers of knowledge, even after the V's had ripped them from their jungle homeworld. The Kelth were the most anxious of the Abiru races. Quick to anger and to joy, they were the most short-tempered, but also the most energetic of the servant races. They had been slaves so long, their homeworld had been forgotten. Small, agile, with long muzzles and sharp eyes and ears, they had learned to survive centuries of V's oppression. These and other species lived by the thousands under the yoke of the V's. But there came a time during the reign of Samrad Ka when one of these Abiru, a tiny Arun cub named Ampress, was taken into the palace of the mighty Ka. There, Ampress became the pet of the Ka's daughter and heir, Izrai. But as Ampress's body grew, so too did her fiery spirit. A wise old scholar named Bish taught her that the Abiru had not always been slaves, and he revealed to her the secret of a precious crystal called the Eye of Clarity. Somewhere, locked within it, lay the secret power of the universe. But Ampress's rebellious nature proved her undoing. Forced to leave her beloved Izrai, she was sold to a family in a distant city. Her only memento of her former life was the Eye of Clarity, given to her by Izrai herself. Rising up against her cruel V's overseer, Ampress killed him and fled, only to be captured and sold into service at one of the most violent of institutions under the V's, the Bloody Gladiator System. Ampress was purchased by the ruthless instructors of the Bizai Moad Gladiator School. And now, after several years of grueling training, she is finally ready to graduate and be sold at auction. But first, she must prove herself in one final combat.
Soon it will be our turn in the ring, Ampress.
Quit sharpening your fangs, Shear. This combat is for points, not for blood.
I think the judges will give me more points if I have your blood on my hands.
Shear, there's no reason for us to hate each other. We're both Aroons. It's the V's that have turned us into enemies.
You won't be able to talk your way out of this fight, Ampress. I'll take Savalhar. I'll take first blood.
Stay back, Shear. Keep your claws inside your own cage or I'll bite them off.
Keep quiet, you two! Save it for the ring, or I'll activate your restraint collars.
Keep it down, Shear. I don't want to get shocked because of you.
Since our first day of training, I've waited for this. Soon, my score will be the highest in the school. I will bring much money at auction. I will be bought by the Blues or the Greens. You will lie dead on the sand and they will throw your bones to the carrion eaters.
Boasts do not draw blood. You won't beat me.
I will sink my teeth into your soft throat before any referee can stop me. I taste your blood already.
You'll never get the chance.
Don't think I don't know what you did, pretty Empress. I know you asked permission to be trained to stay here as an instructor. You don't have the stomach for fighting.
Just because I don't want to spend the rest of my life killing other Abiru for the pleasure of these aristocrats doesn't mean that I'm...
The rest of your life will not be very long at all. The last fight is finished. Can you smell the blood, Empress? It is time!
You there, trainee 11A. Stand still while I prepare you for battle.
But you're removing my battle harness. I'll be totally unprotected.
Silence! It is forbidden to speak to a handler. Here is your weapon. Now run to the center of the ring like you know what you're doing. Hurry, the judge is watching.
Carrying nothing but her weapon, the traditional V's blade known as a glaudoon, Empress sprinted to the center of the arena, then whirled around. She expected to see Shear bearing down on her, but there was no one there.
What's going on? They're not letting Shear out of her cage.
Scoring is halted. Combat is challenged by trainee 11A to instructor. Open rules.
Open rules? But that means to the death.
Trainee to be fought by chief instructor Mobar.
Mobar? He's the toughest instructor in the Bizai Moat.
So you don't want to leave the litter, huh, little cub?
Mobar, please. I don't want to fight you. I just want to stay here and be an instructor. I don't want to spend my life killing or trying not to be killed.
Don't worry, Golden One. You won't be at it for long. As for being an instructor, you can have my spot. All you have to do is kill me first.
Before she could react, Mobar, an Arun much larger and heavier than Empress, lunged forward with terrifying speed. His own weapon flashed in the artificial lights of the arena. Panicked, Empress forgot her training and cowered, ducking just as Mobar's glaudoon sliced the air over her head.
Come on, Empress! I thought I'd trained you better than that!
What's that?
The other trainees. They're cheering for you, Empress. You could never be an instructor here. You make friends when you should be grinding them into the ground. You make them like you when they should fear you the way you fear me. Much better, Empress. Now you're getting the...
Sabal, ha! You forget just how well you trained me, Mobar.
A mistake I won't make again!
The blood pouring from his wound filled Mobar with battle fury. Desperate, Empress fought back with equal rage. The two Aruns were killing machines, slashing at one another with swords and claws and fangs. But somewhere in the back of her mind, Empress knew that they were killing machines created by the Bees. The primal fighting instincts of the Arun people had been corrupted for the entertainment of their masters. But even if Empress had wanted to plead with Mobar to stop, she could not. Her breath came in rasps. Her tired arms felt like they were made of stone. Sensing her fatigue, Mobar moved in close, using his weight against her.
You tired, little cub? Too tired to defend against this? It's a good thing they put you against me now. You wouldn't have made it through your rookie season anyway!
I didn't want to fight you, Mobar. But if it's death you want, you can have it! I did it.
blood on you, yours or his?
I killed him.
Stupid Abiru, how much of the blood on you is yours?
I have a cut on my thigh, the rest is his.
Claim your victory.
What?
You are being acknowledged. Raise your hands above your head in the victory salute. As you have been instructed, claim your victory.
Oh.